Hey guys, Candace Arzu here, the marketing mentor. And in this video, I want to ask those of you again in direct sales and network marketing, are you the person doing all the home parties for everyone on your team? Are you the person doing all of the presentations, the person on all of the three-way upline calls? I relate to that. I can feel you. If that's you, I was there and I was running around like a madwoman. When I first started off in direct sales, I dove into figuring out every single thing I needed to know or I thought I needed to know in relation to my company, in relation to my products, in relation to building a business, because of course it is building a business. I hope you guys that are involved do know that it is not a get rich quick scheme. It is definitely a business. Great for supplementing your income or becoming your primary. So that's my plug for direct sales and network marketing that I believe in it. But if you are the only person spinning your wheels, spending so much time away from your family, which is one, not why you got involved anyway, didn't you get involved to spend more time with your family? Yeah, that was me. I was out of my house so much when I first started because sadly, my training, I guess, was too good because no one else wanted to do the presentations. I was the one, I was it. And the reason I'm telling you this is because what I had to learn, and I have to tell you the story that was told to us by the co-founder of the marketing training program that I'm involved with. He told the story of helping a butterfly break out of his cocoon before he's ready. Like, if you, and I know I'm not saying it right, whatever, if you help a butterfly break out of his cocoon, he will die. Why? Because his wings are not yet strong enough to fly. You've basically stifled him from learning what he needed to learn in order to fly out of that cocoon. This is what I'm telling you is what I was doing for my team. I was stifling them, I was stifling their growth, I was basically killing them off by trying to help them break out of their shell. I was not allowing them to have the freedom to learn it. I wasn't thinking I was empowering them at the time, and I was not. I was holding their hand and not allowing them to truly build their business and get to those stumbling blocks that we need to get to basically to learn anything. I was trying to prevent them from having the stumbling blocks, thinking, oh, let me stop them from, doing something wrong so that hopefully it would help them in their business, and it had the exact opposite effect. I cannot even explain to you when I grasped the concept, and I don't know if I said that word right, grasped the concept that I had to let them fly. I had to basically be like the mother eagle and push them out of the nest and let them learn how to fly, or else they were never going to get anywhere. So when you figure that out, that you cannot hold your reps' hands and do everything for them, guess what? Your team is going to actually thank you for it because it's going to allow them to become more successful because they learn things that they need to know. They go through the stumbling blocks that they have to go through in order to get to the level of success. The road to success is not easy. It's not supposed to be. If it's too easy, you did not learn enough. Let me just tell you that right now. So that's all I wanted to share with you on that video. Stop holding hands. Stop trying to break the butterflies out of their cocoon and help them all succeed. That's it. I will see you guys on the next video. If you're not connected with me on my fan page, click on that link below. Chat with me. Ask me some questions in the comments. I will try to answer all of your questions about all of this stuff. I promise I will. See you soon. Bye.